AstraZeneca Pharmaceuticals is hands down one of the top 5 pharmaceutical stocks over here in the London Stock Exchange. If you haven't heard about them before, then chances are you're going to be hearing about them right now, guys, because this company has got in the UK the closest that we've ever been to creating a viable vaccine to fight against coronavirus. But from a UK stock market investor's perspective, how will all of this reflect on AstraZeneca Pharmaceutical stocks, you know? Could we be on to the next big winner with this stock right here over the coming years? Well, let's find out in this video right here, guys. But first, if you guys are liking these videos that I'm releasing each and every Sunday at 3 p.m. then don't keep it a secret, guys. Pass on the message to YouTube so that they can promote more of my videos towards you guys out there. And the best way to do that is liking this video, sharing it too, and subscribing with the notification bell on as well. Now, back onto AstraZeneca Pharmaceutical stocks with the ticker symbol AZN.L in the FTSE 100 London Stock Exchange. And right now, guys, they have a current share price of around £80 per share. Now, if you were to really ask me to invest in this stock under normal conditions, I'd probably tell you guys, yeah, just keep it moving, look elsewhere, because it's expensive to just buy one share in this stock. But as you guys already know, we're not under normal times right now for any of us. And so I'll be doing you guys a disservice if I didn't explore this stock further right here. Because of the unprecedented times that we're in, guys, I can really see this stock gaining in the short term at the very least. The key part is just that they need to make sure that they release this vaccine and beat their rivals to it in the UK. And the main reason why I believe this to be the case is because of what the stock market represents. It represents the public's perception of a group of stocks. It isn't necessarily what the truth is. It's what we, the people, the investors, see as the truth in our eyes. Now, the reason why I mention this, guys, is because I want it to sink into your head as I explain my reasoning. Because the whole world, it doesn't matter where you're from, everyone's in the same boat right now. We're in a boat of desperation, guys. Everyone is desperate for a coronavirus vaccine. So as soon as you have a company like AstraZeneca Pharmaceuticals saying, hey, we have a solution for you, here you go, naturally as a human race, guys, we're going to flock towards it because we're coming from a state of desperation. And one thing that drives the price up the most is desperation, guys. And this is why I see it really gaining in the short term. Granted, they do manage to release this vaccine and beat their rivals to it in the UK. But what will keep AstraZeneca Pharmaceuticals growing in the long term, as opposed to a short-term burst of growth, is whether this vaccine will make them money or not. And honestly speaking, guys, I think it'll take a bit of a dip after this short-term growth before you can really see some long-term gain from this stock. And it's because of this right here, guys, the fact that they're not looking to take any profits during the current pandemic. Now, there's 4 ways to really view this. The very first way is the easiest way to see it, and it's that it's a very ethical thing for them to do. The fact that they're not looking to profit from the current situation, the vulnerable situation that the UK is in, is very honourable and admirable for them to say, you know, especially when their rivals are not saying the same either. But as you guys are probably thinking about it, this leads on to the second way of viewing it. Like, it's a perfect, ideal opportunity for AstraZeneca Pharmaceuticals to make some serious money. So by choosing to not take any profits during the current pandemic, you know, they're effectively shooting themselves in the foot and helping their competitors gain one up on them in the long run, you know. But this also leads on to the third way of viewing it, because they would have already considered this. You know, they would have already known that they're putting themselves in an uncomfortable situation and indirectly helping their competitors, but yet they still chose to publicly announce that they're not taking any profits. Now, that heavily indicates how financially stable this stock could be, especially when considering that we're going through a current pandemic and many other companies are on the brink of bankruptcy, if not already bankrupt. For them to make this statement, guys, it's just a very compelling statement to make to investors, you know. It just shows that they've got enough in the bank and probably are making enough for them to be comfortable in this situation. And no doubt would the UK government appreciate this and probably be more generous to AstraZeneca Pharmaceuticals specifically, maybe through higher tax relief, you know, more grants and other governmental incentives, you know. It will probably be the case of you scratch my back, I'll scratch your sort of thing. And the fourth way to see it, the clue is in the last 2 words of the newspaper title, you know, in pandemic. Heavily implying that once we're out of the pandemic, it's a completely different ballgame, you know. And what is the official cutoff point of the pandemic? As far as I'm concerned, their cutoff point could be the end of 2020, or it could even be tomorrow, guys. The point is, the power's in their hands. AstraZeneca Pharmaceuticals, they know what they're doing, guys. They're being very clever here. Either way you look at it, if AstraZeneca Pharmaceutical manages to get this vaccine through the gates in the UK first, the stock is only going to go upward. Just depends on how much money they want to make from this vaccine. I can very easily see this vaccine being offered to patients like the annual flu jab several years from now. Just think of how much money they're going to make from it, guys. It's crazy. It all just depends on when AstraZeneca Pharmaceuticals change their mindset of this vaccine from it being a necessity to helping people, you know, to something else, a financial product upon which they can gain from. What I will say though is that all of what I've talked about in this video is so heavily dependent on AstraZeneca Pharmaceuticals making this vaccine and beating their rivals to it in the UK. But what if their rivals end up beating them? All of this gets jeopardized, guys. That's why I always say, guys, make sure you do your research first on a stock, you know, understand the fundamentals, because that way, when you strip all the news and all the he say, she says that could possibly end up failing for that stock, you know that you've still got a good solid stock to invest in. And if you guys want me to make a video on AstraZeneca Pharmaceutical Stock's financial documents, which is a huge chunk of this fundamental analysis that I'm talking about, then let me know down in the comment box below, guys. I'll be happy to make a video for it if the demand is there. I hope you guys have enjoyed watching this video, but as much as I've enjoyed making it, guys, it takes time making these videos. So if you could smash that like button, share it too, and subscribe with notification bell on if you haven't done so already, it will go a long way as to helping my channel get out there more on YouTube. It's your favorite YouTuber, guys, Dear Slim Finance, sharing my thoughts and my experiences with you guys every Sunday at 3 p.m. Have a good day, people. Bye. Whoa.